Well, it's hard to tell how the Anthropocene will look like, but what we certainly know is that it will be a hothouse, that we will experience temperatures that may be close to 50 degrees C in some areas, so for instance in parts of Africa. We know that this will be a poor Earth in the sense of biodiversity, so we will lose a lot of species from this planet, and it means that the geography of the Earth will change completely, because if sea level will rise by several meters, then you have to draw a new map of the Earth. Well, one important implication is, of course, that we lose the beauty of the coral reefs. Okay, so we are all enjoying this wonderful system, and it would be a shame, you know, if we can't preserve this for the following generations. Well, I studied meteorology and did my degree in oceanography, and I did it at a climate institute. Okay, so when I did my graduate work, I worked on El Nino, a climate phenomenon, a short-term climate phenomenon. But also my colleagues, you know, worked on problems of global warming, and you know, this basically motivated me to get myself into global warming and to try to understand what the consequences of global warming could be. I am optimistic because although it doesn't really look like, if you watch the international negotiations, but I think in the end the renewable energies will prevail, okay, because it is just a better option, okay, in all respects, and therefore I'm still optimistic that we can save the planet. I think there are two ways. One is that you need role models or role countries like Germany. So we have shown that you can use renewable energies, okay, and you know, there are many countries following basically what Germany is doing. The other is networking. So nowadays we have possibilities which didn't exist, say, 20 years ago. So we have the internet, okay, so we can communicate globally, you know, instantly. And I think this is a good way to spread the news and to get engaged and to put pressure on the international politics.